360 videos are not for everyone. In this video, we'll find out why, and we'll learn 3 simple rules for knowing when to shoot in 360. We'll also learn that even if you don't want to shoot a 360 video, you can use a 360 camera to create shots that would normally take hundreds if not thousands of dollars of equipment. So whether you love 360 videos or you don't care about them, you'll learn useful techniques in this video. Hi, my name is Mick and you're watching 360 Rumors, the resource that 360 shooters trust for in-depth 360 camera reviews and innovative techniques. I love 360 and VR, but I also know that 360 is not for everything and it's not for everyone. Let's talk about why. First, it's not for everything. Some things look good in 360 and others not really. To understand why, let's compare 360 videos and 360 photos. 360 photos are awesome and they're very useful for real estate or virtual tours or vacations. There's so many uses for them and they're becoming more and more popular. I created several groups on Facebook for 360 and the fastest growing among them is this one called Virtual Tour Network, and it's growing at 20% per month. So 360 photos, no question, go for it. But 360 videos are different. Some things that work as a 360 photo won't work as a 360 video. Because as a viewer, you have limited time to look around in a 360 video. So as a viewer, you can feel like you're missing out on something or you might be confused on where to look. So that's one of the reasons why 360 video is such a challenging medium. So when's it good to shoot in 360? Well, here are 3 guidelines. First, special time or place. 360 videos are great when you're going to a special place. So that's what makes it perfect when you're going on a once-in-a-lifetime trip on a special tour or vacation. It's also great for a special time like a wedding or a special birthday. Tip number 2, what's it like? A 360 video can let you experience what it's like to see things from a different perspective. So for example, one of the 360 videos that I made recently is what's it like to be a piece of sushi. Tip number 3, think about non-360. If your video is going to look just as good, if not better, in non-360, then chances are it doesn't belong in 360. So for example, a talking head video, or you're just walking down a typical looking street, or a room full of girls dancing, no comment. Now if it doesn't pass at least one of these tests, it probably doesn't belong in 360. But maybe you're wondering, what's the harm in shooting it in 360? Well, that brings me to my second point, because 360 is not for everyone. A couple of years ago, I did a 360 video and I shared it with my friends. And one of them mentioned that he didn't look around the 360 video. And the thing is, he's a 360 shooter. So it really drives home the point that some people just don't want to look around in a 360 video. Another thing is that even in 2018, very few people have VR headsets, even a simple Google Cardboard. And we have to remember that shooting and viewing in 360 is very different from shooting and viewing in a traditional video. So that's one of the reasons why there are some photographers or videographers who don't like 360 or simply don't care about it. And if that's you, I'm not here to change your mind. Because the cool thing is that 360 cameras can be useful to anyone. One way to think of 360 is just another lens in your collection. If you've been shooting a long time, chances are you have everything from a telephoto all the way to a fisheye. So you might be wondering why get another lens. Well, 360 is probably the most versatile focal length you'll ever use. And here's why. With the right 360 camera, you can create shots that would take hundreds if not thousands of dollars of equipment to shoot. So you can get super stabilization, an invisible flying camera view, cinematic camera movements, multicam editing. So normally to get these kinds of effects, you need a lot of equipment. For super stabilization, you'll need a gimbal. For a flying camera effect, you'll need a cameraman with a Steadicam. For cinematic camera movements, you'll probably need a jib. And for multicam, you'll need multiple cameras and cameramen. But a stabilized 360 camera can do all those while fitting in your pocket. So using 360, especially as B-roll, can give your videos a higher production value. The key to getting these effects from a 360 camera is to use Overcapture video or reframed video. Overcapture means that you take the 360 video and convert it to a non-360 video, showing only those parts that you want your audience to see. Now, if you're a hardcore 360 shooter, you might be wondering if Overcapture is taking a step backward. So the way I think about it is kind of like that little blue pill. Originally, Viagra was designed to treat high blood pressure, but people found out that it was good for other things. Can you imagine if Pfizer had said, Well, we designed this specifically for high blood pressure only, so we're only going to be selling it for that purpose. That makes no sense. But is it hard to do overcapture, and do you need expensive software? Not at all. And in part 2, I'm going to show you some free software for overcapture, whether you're on desktop or mobile, whether Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and get this, for any 360 camera. Plus, I'm going to show you the secret technique that experienced shooters use to make their videos look their best.